are now joined by number 4 ranked UFC heavyweight Derek Zingler Rosenstruck, and we'll take the first set of questions from Chris Dekker with Veronica Fight.
Hey Jorginho, het is nu je derde gevecht in de tijd van de pandemie. Wendt die tijd al?
Ja, zou ik zeggen. En we doen gewoon wat om het te doen. We zijn eigenlijk gewoon aan het werk en ja, het moet gebeuren. Dus we doen ons best en zorgen dat we gewoon voorbereid zijn.
Mm. Oh ja. Ja, nu hoor ik je hoor. Ja, ik ben weer terug. Pardon. Het is nu derde gevecht in de tijd van de pandemie. Wendt die tijd al?
Ik zei ja. Het is wat het is. Ik zou wel zeggen dat het went. En we zijn aan het werk en we moeten doen wat we moeten doen. Dus ja, het is niet makkelijk, maar we moeten roeien met de riemen die we hebben. En zorgen dat we gewoon voorbereid zijn voor wat komt.
In Gaan tref jij, net zoals jij, een oud kickbokser. Verwacht je dan ook gewoon een kickboxpartij met MMA handschoenen?
Ja, eigenlijk met deze jongen weet je niet wat hij wil gaan doen. Hij kan gewoon alle kanten gaan, hij kan ook op de grond. Ik zie hij van pass submissions, hij heeft KO's staande. Dus deze jongen ga ik gewoon moeten drukken en kijken wanneer hij een fout maakt en waar hij naartoe wil gaan. Ik ben gewoon voorbereid. En ja, elke fout die er wordt gemaakt wordt direct afgestraft.
Maar wat vind je van hem als kickbokser?
Ik heb nooit een kickboxwedstrijd van hem gezien. Ik vind hem wel een aparte zwaargewicht. Die de hele tijd beweegt. Draait goed weg. En ja, ik zou hem al moeten gaan opvangen.
Ja. Wat zie je ook vergelijkingen met in jezelf met hem? Want hij is ook iemand die overstapt van het kickboksen. Heel erg snel in korte tijd in de top 10 gewerkt heeft. Net zoals jij eigenlijk in de afgelopen 2 jaar hebt gedaan. Zie jij die vergelijking ook?
Nee, dat zie ik niet. Qua kickboksen, ik ben een ander type kickbokser. En hij ook. Ik zie geen vergelijking.
Je bent ook een hele grote underdog. Wat vind je daarvan?
Nou, dat hindert me niet. Het is juist goed, gaan mijn vrienden allemaal geld verdienen.
Het is ook voor hem is het voor het eerst dat hij in een main event vecht, voor jou niet. Eigenlijk zou dit gevecht ook 2 weken eerder plaatsvinden, 2 weken later plaatsvinden en ook zou het 3 ronden zijn. Heeft dat veel impact gehad?
Nee, helemaal geen impact gehad. Ik was al een beetje in shape, dus het was alleen maar gewoon doortrainen. En wat ik 2 weken later kan doen, kan ik ook 2 weken eerder. Dus ik heb er geen moeite mee.
Oké, laatste vraag van mij. Wat denk je wat een zegen je brengt? En hoe denk je dat de zwaargewichtdivisie de komende tijd uitpakt met Miocic tegen Ngannou die aanstaande is, Jones die erin schuift en na de zegens van Lewis en Volkov?
Nou, op dit moment, een win van zaterdag, die gaat me gewoon terugzetten op de nummer 3. En ik wil sowieso nog een keer vechten. En ik wil heel snel terugkeren. Met heel snel bedoel ik dan misschien mei, juni. En dan, daarna wil ik gaan voor een title shot.
Oké, helder. Dankjewel.
Alsjeblieft.
We'll take our next set of questions from Gabriel Gonzalez with K-Tide Press.
Hello, Jorginho. Can you hear me?
Yeah, loud and clear.
Awesome. So, Jorginho, everyone's talking about how many more kickboxing fights you have. How do you feel your experience helps you in a big fight like this one?
Now, I mean, my kickbox experience helped me in all my fights. I have to lay on that. And yeah, I'm been working in my kickbox career almost 14 years. And of course, it helped me because that's what I know it better than anything.
I heard in yesterday's media day that you had made the move to Florida. Can you explain the decision to be in the United States full time? Because I know you are a big deal back home in Suriname.
Yeah, I did. Because especially for my career, I want to focus this 3-4 years just only on my career and learning the MMA game. Of course, I'm a big deal at home, but in Florida, it started happening also. And right now I'm having a headline, so all the tension is on me. And winning this fight this Saturday will make it bigger than anything.
Besides the people, family and friends, of course, what do you miss most from home? Is there any particular food that you just can't find in the United States? What is it?
Yeah, I miss my red beans with chicken and chicken feet and the Suriname way with sausages. Nobody made it here like home.
Well, I certainly hope you're able to find it eventually. My final question, just how do you feel you match up with Cyril stylistically?
No, I think it's an interesting fight. The guy does what he does. He wins his fight. You have to respect that. I see what he does. And that's why I'm taking him seriously. This Saturday is going to be a different type of fight. We're going to see where you want to go. I'm ready. I'm in shape. So it doesn't matter. Let's make it happen.
Hey, thank you, Jairzinho. Good luck.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
We'll take our next set of questions from Jim Barcelone with the Miami Herald.
Thank you. How did training go for this one? You're at American Top Team. Now you said you're living in South Florida. Who helped you prepare for this one and how did training? American Top Team is such a great place.
I have a good training camp at American Top Team. Feeling good. I have my coach Michael Bob with me. King Mo is working with me with my wrestling and Steve Markle. I have Conan Silveira also with me. And I'm working with my strength and conditioning coach from Live Free CrossFit, John Kelly. So I'm in shape. My camp was great. And American Top Team is such a great play, as you mentioned. They help me and they focus particularly on me, especially with my weakest spots.
If we can, in the short version, how did you get to American Top Team? And how has that changed you?
It was my manager. At first, I didn't want to go there because I know American Top Team have a lot of heavyweights. And so I was curious that I'm going to meet them in the future. So I told him, no, I don't want to go there. And then he told me, like, you know what? You owe me one thing. Go there. If you don't like it, I own you one thing. I own you one. And I'm like, all right. Then I went, I checked it out, and I was lost in the place. I mean, so many bodies. The coach is focusing on you. I went there before the fight with Lester. I had only 2 weeks, and they helped me with my preparation and go in that fight and still win that fight. So I think I'm in a great place right now.
Where does a victory in this next big fight, where does it get you to next?
I think a victory in this fight, I win this Saturday, will keep me right where I want to be in the top five. And I want to make a quick turnaround and I want to have a title fight after that.
And how has it been in South Florida? Are you getting used to it here?
Yeah, it's going its way. It's nice, chill. I didn't get a chance to see the city yet or go out and chill a little bit, but time will tell.
Oh, you mentioned red beans and some other things. You got to get down to Miami. There are places down there. I'll send some messages over to ATT so you can try some spots after the fight or something.
Okay, nice. You can send it to my Instagram too, so I get it faster.
Very good, very good. Oh, and lastly for me, what is it like back home? Because how big of a star are you back home? And how much does the country rally around you when you have a fight? And that's it for me. Thank you.
I mean, back home is nice. It's crazy. Everybody's in the hype, especially now. All the kids, all the people sending the good wishes and the love, and everybody hope that I win this Saturday. So this Saturday, I'm going to be on fire. I'm going to knock this guy out.
Thank you.
All right, cool.
We'll take our next set of questions from Marcelo Baroni with Global TV.
Hi, Jairzinho. Can you hear me?
Yes, loud and clear. How you doing?
I'm fine. And you?
Thank you. I'm fine.
Okay. So Cyril Gane and you are part of a new heavyweight generation in the UFC, which is much more competitive and with more fighters on winning streaks. In your opinion, why is the heavyweight division so exciting right now?
I mean, it's exciting because I'm in it. it's exciting. Everybody's fighting. The championship fighting is going to go on next month. I'm fighting this Saturday. A couple of heavyweight just fought a week ago. And now the future is bright. Everybody's fighting. So, you know, your place after this one. And yeah, the future is bright. Who wins that fight next month? And then, yeah, I'll be ready. Get one more fight before that. And I want to fight a title shot after that.
And what's your opinion about your opponent? Do you believe that he also has potential to be a UFC champion?
Yeah, I think he has his potential, but not against me. This Saturday, I'm going to change all the things about that because it's my time and I'm going to shine this Saturday.
Okay, thank you so much.
No problem.
We'll take our next set of questions from Santiago Jar with AT5.
Hi, Biggie. Greetings from Amsterdam. I will take a couple of questions in Dutch. Hey, Biggie boy. Je staat alweer klaar voor jouw tweede UFC main event. Je zit nu net 2 jaar in de UFC en je hebt echt al je visitekaartje afgegeven met een paar verwoestende knockouts. Voel je je gewaardeerd door de UFC, Biggie? En hoe blij zou het jou maken als de UFC richting jouw geboorteplaats Paramaribo zou komen in de toekomst om daar een mooi evenement te organiseren?
Nou, ten eerste groetjes terug en ja, het zou geweldig zijn als de UFC gewoon naar Suriname komt en gewoon een event neerzet. En ja, ik word gewaardeerd, zeg maar. Ik ben altijd een vechter geweest die altijd hard heeft gewerkt en gewoon mijn best heb gedaan. Maar nu ben ik op een plek dat gewoon mijn hard werk gewoon wordt gewoon beloond en het wordt gewoon gezien door iedereen. En dat voelt natuurlijk goed aan. En ja, naar de top gaan is pas het begin. Kampioen worden, dat is het doel en kampioen blijven.
Dan de laatste vraag voor mij, Biggie. Hoe belangrijk is trainer Michael Babb voor jou en waar hebben jullie in deze fightcamp op gefocust?
Michael is los van trainer, is hij ook gewoon een hele goede vriend en hij is ook een mentor. Hij is eigenlijk betrokken in mijn hele leven. Waar we op hebben gefocust? We focussen altijd gewoon op wat we kunnen doen en wat we goed kunnen doen. En in de afgelopen 6-7 maanden hebben we gewoon veel geworsteld, veel jiu-jitsu gedaan. Dus we werken gewoon aan onze stijl. We leren nog steeds de MMA spelletje. Maar het gaat de goede kant op en we vertrouwen aanstaande zaterdag.
Je ziet er in een goede shape uit. Bedankt voor de tijd, hè, Brada. En veel succes op zaterdag. Thank you so much.
Dankjewel, man. Tot de volgende keer.
We'll take our next set of questions from Pablo Santamaria with Nate MMA Equity.
Hey, Jairzinho. Can you hear me?
Loud and clear. How are you doing?
Everything is okay. Thanks for asking me. The first thing I want to ask you is, what are your thoughts on Cyril Gane as an opponent?
Nah, I think the guy does his things, he wins his fight. And yeah, I see it, I respect it, but I'm a different type of fighter. When I go in the octagon, I just want to knock somebody out. Yeah, that's how I think of it, about him.
Okay, do you think he will try to take you down because you have a lot of knockout power?
I mean, every fighter, when the game plan with every fighter that fight against me or match against me, they start sharpening their ground game because they think that's my weakest spot. But guess what? Lesson will be learned. This Saturday is going to be a different type of game, and we're going to see who tries.
Okay. A big fight between Stipe Miocic and Francis Ngannou is coming. Who do you got in that fight? Who do you think is going to win?
I mean, it's a huge fight. It's the gold on the line for my division. Who wins, I don't care. I mean, who sits on the throne, that's the person we're after. And yeah, that's it.
Okay, and if you get the W, do you want to call someone out? Do you have an opponent in your mind?
No, I don't have nobody in mind. I mean, everybody that's ranked above me, that makes sense. This Saturday will keep me right where I want to be in the top 5, and I want to make a quick turnaround and fight someone else, and after that I want to go for the title.
And my last one is what are your thoughts about John Jones going for the title? It doesn't matter who wins, Ngannou or Miocic.
No, I mean, the guy deserves it. He was the light heavyweight champion. He defeated his title. And he's one of the best coming to my division. He go before me, I'm fine with it. I'm going to be fighting in the meanwhile, getting better. That when that fight come against John Jones, I want to win that fight. That make me the best.
Okay, and would you like to send a message to your Ecuadorian fans?
One more time?
Would you like to send a message to your Ecuadorian fans?
Of course. Everybody watch this fight. I'm going to be victorious. I'm going to be their shine, and as always, shout out and love to you guys.
Okay, thank you very much for your time, Biggie Boy, and good luck on the fight.
No problem. Thank you, sir.
We'll take our next set of questions from Augusto Herman with Somos MMA.
Hey, Jairzinho, how are you?
I'm good. How are you, sir?
I'm fine, thank you. Jairzinho, you have said that you don't feel ready for a title fight right now. So I am curious, in your opinion, what is missing? Which aspects of your game do you think you need to improve?
It's not that I have to improve something on my game. It's more that I want to be more in the wash machine, fighting more often. So when the title fight comes, you're ready. We can train all day. We can train all night. We can train all year. But if you don't fight, you don't see your development. You don't see how you develop. Because if I'm sparring with you every day, that means I know what you're going to do next. But when I'm going to be fighting, it's always different. And that makes me more, it gives me more belief in what I do. And winning fight is what I'm looking for. So that makes me feel ready for a title fight. So that's why after this fight, I want to make a quick turnaround, get one more fight, and then I want to go for the title.
Okay, I imagine that's why you have also said that you want a quick turnaround. So I want to know, who do you think would be the best matchup for you inside the top five of the division for a quick turnaround? And considering that the title picture right now is like frozen because Stipe will face Ngannou and then John Jones will step on the line. So who do you think would be the best matchup for you?
I mean, everybody that's ranked above me, it makes sense. And a victory this Saturday, we're going to see who is available. And then, yeah, I will fight anyway, so it doesn't matter.
So you wouldn't consider to fight against someone outside the top five?
Maybe. That's not what I'm looking for. Anyone that's ranked above me makes sense.
Okay. I'm talking about the fight on Saturday. Which type of fight do you imagine on Saturday?
I don't know yet. This guy is a different guy. He likes to move, jump a lot. I see he has some submissions. He has some knockouts. So I'm going to be in there looking for the opportunity, squeeze him. If he make that mistake, I can put him down. I'm the fighter who's able to knock somebody out. So any mistake will be punished with a knockout.
Okay, awesome. Thank you very much, Jairzinho, and good luck on Saturday, man.
Thank you, sir.
We'll take our last set of questions from Martina Zalouch with Indicage.pl.
Hello, sir. How are you?
I'm good. How are you, ma'am?
I'm great, thank you. So just three quick questions. First of all, I would like to know, in your opinion, does Derrick Lewis deserve for title shot after his last win?
Of course. I mean, Derrick Lewis has been there forever and he's knocking people out since then. And after his last performance, that nice knockout, give the man a title shot. He deserves it.
Is it okay that John Jones will get this title shot before him?
Yeah. I mean, John Jones is one of the best. He figured his style at light heavyweight. For me, if you go before me, I'm fine with it. I think the man deserves it, so give it to him.
Okay. Can you share your prediction for next week main event between Błachowicz and Israel Adesanya?
For me, I don't have prediction, but I always a really exciting fight. Both fighters are phenomenal. I mean, if Adesanya wins, he does something for the sport, being double champ. That's something that not everybody can do, so it's going to be amazing. Jan always work hard, and he's going there, and he's a hard hitter, hard kicker. So I hope it's excitement to watch, and I'm going to enjoy the fight.
Great. And the last thing from me, do you see other MMA talents in Suriname? I'm asking not only about heavyweight.
Of course, there is not only heavyweight, but there's a lot of talent in Suriname. I think there are some managers or trainers to come to Suriname and see prospects and bring them to the States and let them train, and you're going to see different type of style that we have there.
And some female MMA fighters also?
One more time?
And some female MMA fighters also?
Of course, there's a few MMA fighters, and that's a lot. But the thing is, if you don't get a chance, I'm lucky that I got a chance with Mike. He bring me to the Netherlands, and then from the Netherlands, we fought all over the world, and all over Europe, even mm-hmm. Russia. The only place that I didn't fought before the UFC was in America. And there is where the biggest chances are. So if somebody give those guys a chance, I think there will be much more fighters from Suriname in the UFC, because they are such great talents and we are strong.
Okay, thank you, sir. It was a pleasure.
Thank you. Bye. Done?
That's all we have for you today, Jarzinho. Thank you.
Well done.